Finally. I have to admit, when I'm out on the glacier and we're carrying all the gear and we're at high elevation and you're working really hard, I definitely ask myself whether I really want to be doing this. But you look at the scenery, and there's really no other place that I would rather be at that moment.
Logistical issues with monitoring these glaciers are about the toughest part of this. Getting to them safely and back safely requires an awful lot of work, and so we depend on having staff at Mount Rainier and North Cascades. There are several reasons we monitor these glaciers. They're habitat for certain species, and they're part of the alpine food web. They're a tremendous indicator of climate change. But probably the most important reason we monitor them is because of the water. And these glaciers provide a substantial amount of water during the summer that fuels the hydroelectric industry in the North Cascades. The glaciers are also providing a considerable amount of meltwater to our rivers and lakes. And so they provide what we call buffering capacity. In the summer, when we get very little rain, these glaciers continue to provide water and buffer our lakes and streams from the summer drought or droughts over longer periods. So we're connected to the lake and the aquatic monitoring, as well as providing this overall weather and climate information.
So in the spring, when we come out and we are placing the ablation stakes, we rely on this steam drill, which the insides is basically like a camping stove. We have a propane tank, we fill it with water, we heat up the water, and it produces steam. You know, the pressure builds inside, we release the pressure, and then we have a 13-meter hose that the steam comes out of that we drill directly into the glacier. We drilled 13 meters and we place the ablation stake down in the glacier, and then we can come back and watch it melt off that stake.
We monitor glaciers by visiting them at least twice a year, and the idea is that we want to measure how much snow the glaciers accumulate on their surface in the winter, and then by melting stakes into the glacier in the spring, we can monitor how much of that snow and the ice beneath it melts through the summer. Our observations have indicated that the glaciers in the North Cascades have decreased about 50% in area in the last century or so.
So we've been studying the two glaciers, Nisqually and Emmons, at Rainier since 2002, and every year there's been a net loss. I think it's been about 1 to 2 meters of water equivalent loss throughout the whole glacier, which ends up being billions of gallons of water. If the public could actually see the measurements that we are seeing and see the glacier and how it changes every year and the amount that sometimes looks like it's falling apart or the snow field looks like it's actually rotting, it just becomes much more real of the impact that climate change could have.
Monitoring glaciers is important because they're giving us a really dramatic measure of the climate change and the global disruption that we're seeing in climate right now. That has been really important for reaching the public and helping them understand this global climate change that's occurring.